सह कृच्छ्रीभूत अप्रत्याख्येयं ब्राह्मणं मन्वानो भाषण ऑफ दिस मंत्राष्ट सह ही कृच्छ्रीभूत हैविंग बिकम सॉरोफुल अप्रत्याख्येयं ब्राह्मणं मन्वानो एंड थिंकिंग दैट ए ब्राह्मण हु हैज कम इन दिस वे कैन नॉट बी रिफ्यूज्ड अप्रत्यक्ष मीन्स कैन नॉट बी रिफ्यूज्ड मनवाना थिंकिंग सो ए ब्राह्मण हु हैज कम इन दिस वे कैन नॉट बी रिफ्यूज्ड सो व्हाट शुड बी डन न्यायेन विद्या वक्तव्या इति मत्वा सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रूल्स दैट हैज बीन सेट in the Upanishads to impart knowledge. According to those rules, I will have to impart this knowledge now to this person. Iti matva, thinking so, tamha Gautamam, to that Gautama who had come, chiram means dirghakalam vasityam ajnapayan chakara. You will have to be in brahmacharya in this ashram, in my house, for long, long time. Knowingly answered this. The first refusal, total refusal was in the first one, statement. You can have human wealth. That means I don't want to give you any knowledge. He knows why he has come. The son was being insulted, he felt insulted, he went away, and then the father is coming. It's very clear that this fellow has come for knowledge. Therefore, you are indirectly refusing by saying, whatever you wish, human wealth, please ask for that. That statement itself shows 100% refusal. And now, the second time is indirectly refusing is by asking to say for indefinite time. That was 100% refusal, this partial refusal. I am ready to give you, if you have got that much, so much patience, if you are ready to wait for 1 or 2, 3 years, then after that I will ready to give, I will give you the knowledge. Therefore, there it is total refusal. By saying, take human wealth. And here is partial refusal by asking him to stay for an indefinite period. But Anandagiri says, here, even though dirghakalam, chiram is dirghakalam, indefinite it is, but you have to take the samvatsaram vasiti yavat. I don't know from where he has got some pramana, depending on that is telling. Anandagiri is telling, therefore we have to accept it. Samvatsaram vasiti. 1 year at least he had to stay over. That means to say after 1 year he has imparted the education. Until then he was in Brahmacharya there only. Ityam ajnapayanchakara ajyaptavan. He ordered to him. Yat puram pratyakhyatavan raja vidyam. Yatcha paschachiram vasiti ajyaptavan. You see what he has done. Yat puram pratyakhyatavan. Puram pratyakhyatavan is he had refused. The king had refused to impart the knowledge at first. Purva means before. And Paschat later was telling, Chiram vasa iti ajyaptavan. He said, come on, be here, stay for a long time. And then later he ordered him to stay. That means what? Excuses. No, no, he's given excuses for not trying to give the knowledge. But at the same time, he knows, this is a Brahmin fellow. These people are behind Vidyas. Whichever Vidya they want to get, they will be ready to go anywhere and stay any long time and do whatever they want to do. They are ready to do.
And they are learning
Vidya. They want Vidya. They are ready to suffer anything because of Vidya. And he knows that this fellow will not go even after 10 years also ready to stay, even then also he will be sitting here only. He will not go. Therefore, at the same time what is telling you by mentioning this, he is saying, he is begging a pardon from that Brahman for having totally refused before, and now for partial refusal also, he is asking a pardon. And gives reason also, why I had refused before 100% and why I am refusing now partially, for that both he is giving reason also at the same time. The reason is what? Until this day, no Brahman had got this Vidya at all. This is the reason. This statement itself is the reason for refusing. Why is Vidya? Yasma paschachiram vasiti adhyatman. Tan nimittam brahmanam kshamapayati hetu vachanoktya. For that, tan nimittam for that refusal, now he begs pardon from that Brahmin. Brahmanam kshamapayati. He is begging pardon from that Brahmin by stating the following statement, which includes the reason for refusal. Hetu vachan uktya. So for that he begs the pardon of the Brahmin by uttering the following sentence, which gives reason also for refusing. What is the statement? Tamovacha Raja Sarvavidyo Brahmanopi San Yatha Yena Prakarna Mama Mamas Mam Prati He Gotama Avadaha Tam Tami Vidya Lakshanam Vacha Me Bruhiti Ajnanat Tena Tam Jani Se Tam Hovacha. To him he said, who? The Raja, king. Sarvavid. How is that Brahmin? He is Sarvavid. Although you have possessed of all knowledge and you are running a bit of Gurukula, and this fellow, the king Jayavali himself, was a student of that Gurukula. Therefore, he knows Gautama has got all knowledge. He says, Sarvavid, you are possessed of all knowledge. And not only that, by caste also, you are higher caste to me. I am a Kshatriya, you are a Brahmana. Brahmanopisan, being a Brahmin and possessed of all knowledge. But still what you did? Yatha, yena prakar, the way in which you have presented yourself in front of me as a disciple to get this knowledge. Maam is maam prati. Towards me, the way in which you have presented yourself in front of me. Hey Gautama, oh Gautama. And the words that you utter, avada, what you have said? Tame vidya lakshanam vacham me bruhi. I don't want any other wealth. Anything else other than that form of knowledge which you had put in the form of question in front of my son. Tameva vidya lakshanam vacham ebruhi iti. And at the same time, the other greatness of yours is being such a knowledgeable person, you have shown your ignorance regarding this vidya. Ajnana tena tam jani. You have shown your ignorance. That is the great simplicity of a Brahmin you can see here. Being such a great scholar, going in front of a person is of lower caste and not such knowledgeable also. He possesses only that vidya, nothing else, much. But still he has gone for that single vidya to him. So, through showing your ignorance, you have forced me indirectly to give this vidya now. Tena tvam jani. Therefore, now there is no other go for me. I have to give your knowledge. This knowledge, you will have this knowledge for yourself. Tatrasti vaktavyam. There is this thing to be said over here. Yatha, yena prakarana yam vidya. What is the reason he is giving? He is telling because as to how up to this day, the way in which this vidya, yam vidya means this knowledge, praktvatto, before you, Brahmana Nagachati Nagatavadi. It has never gone to the Brahmins. That was the main reason why I wanted to refuse before and later also try to delay it. Nacha Brahmana Anayavitaya Anushasitavanta. That means to say, never Brahmins had been instructed by this knowledge, by this meditation. Tathaitat Prasidam Lokya. Since it is very well known in this world, yataha, because, tasma, therefore, pura, purvam, in the past, sarveshu lokeshu, in all the countries existing on this world, kshatra siva, kshatra jatireva, anayavidya prashasanam, prashastrittam, shishyanam abhut, babuva. By virtue of this knowledge itself, anayavidya, by the virtue and the blessings and the kripa of this knowledge itself, that we of the caste, Kshatriya caste only, had owned the prashasana, means prashastrittam, the teachership, towards the students regarding this vidya, babuva, we had been so. Kshatriya parampraya evayam vidya etavantam kalam agatha. That means to say, this knowledge had been coming from one to another, had come up to this day has come from one to another through a succession of Kshatriya teachers only. That's the main reason I did not want to break this succession and give to a Brahmin, and for that it will go into the Brahmin succession also. This is the reason why I had delayed and refused, for both the reasons. This is the reason he has given for refusal and delay. Tathapi, even though it was so, aham, peri, what I am going to do now is, etam tubhyam vaksha, but still, I am going to now impart this knowledge to you. Or vakshyami is in future tense. Then we can take, until I shall spell out this to you, impart this knowledge to you, until then, the teachers will be with Kshatriyas only. After imparting, then you will become the first Brahmin teacher of this Vidya. Thus, iti tat sampradanat urdham, you see, after being imparted to you, tat sampradanat, imparted to you, after that, urdham, brahmanam gamishyati, this Vidya will go into the hands of Brahmins also. Ato maya yaduktam takshantum varat. Therefore, the way I had refused you and the way I have delayed for both those things, takshantum varati, I deserve to be pardoned by you. I am deserved to be pardoned by you. Ityukta, having said so, tasmai hovacha vidyam raja, the king imparted this knowledge of meditation to him, the Gautama. Now there is a lot of introduction to this first mantra. Again, one full paragraph is there before taking up the mantra. Two paragraphs. Chaliye. Panchamya bhautau apaiti ayam prashna prathamena apakriyate. Panchamya bhautau apaha iti ayam prashna. The fifth question is being first answered. Among those five questions, the question and answer system is going in a reverse order now. The king is answering to his own fifth question first. Why? Panchamyam ahutav apa. How the water comes to be known as person. After the fifth oblation, this was the fifth question. And it is being answered first. The answers are being taught to him in a reverse order. Fifth first, he's telling, because tad apakaranam anu itaresham apakaranam anukulam bhaventi. The reason is given again very clearly, because following the disposal of this first question, answering the rest of the questions becomes very much convenient. Very easy to answer them, really understand very easily. That's the reason why he's doing first, the fifth one. Tad apakaranam, that is the disposal of this fifth question, having answered this question, anu, after that, itresham apakaranam, disposal of other questions, anukulam bhavet, becomes convenient to us. Agnihotrahutya karyarambha ya saukta vasaniya. Because the similar system you can see in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. There also the king asks question. Janaka asks questions to Yajnavalkya about Agnihotra. And everyone replies. There are six questions, not five. Six questions are there. And he has answered his own way, Yajnavalkya. The whole thing is shown here in a short. Bhashyakara shows the whole of Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Verse 3, 1, 5 and 6. 3, 1, 5 and 6. That whole thing is taken, summarized and put together over here by Acharya Shankara. Agnihotra hatyo karyarambho ya sa ukta vajasaniyake. In the Vajasaniyake means in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That which is the result of the two oblations related to Agnihotra is being mentioned there. Has been mentioned over there. That is, daily you give one out in the morning, one out in the evening. Both in the morning and actually, two hours in the morning, two hours in the evening. Agnir Jyotir 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 Agne Swaha. Agnir Jyotir Jyotir Pradyapte Swaha. Then Agnir Jyotir Jyotir Agne Swaha. Agnir Jyotir Jyotir Somaya Swaha. Two in the morning, two in the evening. This is the main hours. Other than that, the main are two hours in the morning and two hours in the evening. But two together is called as one ahuti in the morning, and two together in the evening is one. There were two per day, it is said. So those two oblations are the most important oblations for a Karmakandi Purusha to attain Brahmaloka. How he attains? By doing this daily Agnihotra sacrifice, this rite, by performing the Agnihotra rite daily, how the person attains up to Brahmaloka? That question was put by Janaka to Yajnavalkya. Tam prati prashnaha, this is what started. Tam means Yajnavalkyam prati. To that Yajnavalkya, the questions were put by Janaka. To him, the questions were put like this. Utkranti, short, not all the questions have been here. First question was regarding the departure. Second question was Ahutyor Gati, the ascending order. Third, Pratishtha, the place of resting when they go on the way, where all they'll be resting, the different steps. Fourth, Tripti, the enjoyment in each and every particular station. Fifth, Punaravritti, the descending order towards this world. And lastly, Lokam Pratyutthai. And I entered into which thing that the person becomes ready to appear in this world. That's called Pratyutthai. He is becoming ready to enter this world after entering home. The woman. Because he enters into a woman, into the garbha. Then only he is be fit to come into this world, not before that. Without getting into feminine personality, he cannot come out. Where is any plant or anything also? There also is masculine feminine division in every tree and everything. So therefore he says, without entering his tree cannot come. Then the question was, he had asked to which thing a person enters before entering or appearing into in front of this world. These are the six questions. Departure, how he departs. Then the ascending order, the place of resting, and the enjoyment in that rest place, in the rest house, and descending order, and finally into which he enters, by which he will be able to present himself or produce himself in front of this, appear in front of this world. Pratyutthai. These were six questions put to him. And Varda iti, iti, tesham chapakarana muktam tatriva. And the answers to those questions, the disposal of those questions are given there only by Yajnavalkya. Teva ete ahuti. When these two oblations, hute, are offered, utkramataste, they go up. They go up means in the sense, they actually, what you call, they cover the person who was doing all his life the Agnihotra at the time of his death. They will not be let to be taken by Yamadutas. These ahutis, that is the deities presiding over those ahutis will come and cover that as a guard, they will be there around him. Not let the Yamadutas to drag him to southern direction. So no, he has done Agnihotra the whole life. Therefore he is entitled to go up in the Swargaloka. And they will cover him, and this is how he departs, this body. At the time of departure, these ahutis, that is the deities presiding over these ahutis, come and cover him. This is the process of departure is shown. Then he says, then they take him where? To the first station is Antariksham. The first junction where the train will get halted, it gets tasty and enjoys its fruits, the result of the ahutis. First is intermediate space, Antariksham. Avishadha, and then what they do is, they let him do in one way Agnihotra there also. They will transform this whole of Antarikshaloka as fire. Antariksham eva avaniyam kurvate. They transform this intermediate space into fire. And this whole intermediate space is fire, then what is Samidha? Vayum Samidham. The air that is flowing itself is Samidha. It's the fuel. Marichireva Shuklama Ahuti. And the rays which are passing through this intermediate space of the sun, those rays are itself Shuklama, the white and pure oblation. the Antariksham Darpedaha. And these two Ahutis themselves, what do? They present themselves in front of that performer as the result of the karma and giving whole tripti satisfaction. And he enjoys the results of his own karma. Antariksham Darpedaha. They satisfy that person, that performer, being in that intimate space only. Then, tata utkramada. Then they rise up from there. Ityadi. This is all, the explanation is there, long explanation by Yajjivalkya, which will be shortened by, summarized by Acharya Shankara says now, evam eva purvat, as it has been before. Similarly, divam tarpetaha. Is taken to Dhyuloka, the heavens. There also you have to consider the fire, the fuel, the oblations and everything you have to imagine there also. Transformation of those things in that form. Tatha avartate. From there he again returns back. From there this fellow returns back. After having satisfied over there, after having satisfied each and every station, this performer will get enjoy, he is satisfied, he says, oh, ho gaya, bahut dekh liya, ab chalo yahan se aage. The performer will order them, below, bhai, this is not the final station, let us go further. A green signal is given by station master, come on. Similar, this fellow is going from one station to another. So, after having satisfied, then he goes over there. But while he is going by first year, there will be no decision. At the time of departure, he is going through the path of means or path of gods, depending upon the karma. If he has done with upasana, he will be going on the path of gods. And without upasana, only karma means, he will be going on the path of means. This difference you have to be noted there. Imam Avishya, then he entered into this world in the form of rain, he comes and becomes wheat, rice, many things. And the man eats. Tarpaitva, being in that position, satisfied being there. Being a wheat, you are getting satisfied first. You satisfy, oh, what a beautiful wheat plant I am. Enjoying with all the winds of Ganga and all. Very happy being a wheat there. Then you will go into the mouth of a man. Purusham avishatah. And become a virya of that man. And that virya, tata striyam avishya. You will get satisfied. There go my mardhum. The person is getting satisfied because that wheat is there inside, you know, in the form of viryam, the vital force. Therefore, you will be saying, I am Admiyu, from Auratho, Chopraho. That ahankara comes because of the virya. That is how the jiva, which is form of virya, gets satisfied by the purushattam and the strittam in the woman. And there also it is getting satisfied that way. And both get together. Then tatastriyam avishya, then I entered into a woman, lokam pratyutthayi bhavati, it becomes ready to appear in this world. All of the mantra what is put to Brunanaka is short, Vashikara put it, iti. Tatra agnihotra avatyo karyaram matram evam prakar vityu bhavati tuktam. But why is this vitya saying come in Chandogya then? If the question and answers are there in more detail, why here you have taken up again in this Upanishad? He says there on the result has been told. And each and every station, the Agnihotra has been not told in detail. What is fire? What is fuel? What is what? Purvadeva, just like that, there similarly you have to understand yourself. But you may do your imagination maybe wrong also. Therefore, Chandogya makes it clear at each and every station what should be the imagination. In what you have to see as fire, what you have to see, you look upon as fuel, what you have to look upon as flame, what you have to look upon as the ember, what you have to look upon as the chingara, all those things you have to understand. For that purpose, this Chandogya Upanishad takes up again the whole subject and goes in detail. He says, Tatra, in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, Agnihotra Avatyaha, Karyarama Matram Evam Prakaram Bhavati Ityukta. There in Brihadaranyaka, the commencement of the results of the two oblations offered in the Agnihotra only has been shown. Not in detail. How the result commences and how he is going, that's all has been told. Ihatu, here in this Chandogya Upanishad, but here in this Chandogya Upanishad, tam कार्यारंभ अग्निहोत्र अपूर्व परिणाम लक्षण पंचधा प्रविभज्य वॉट इज यू आर डूइंग इज दैट कमेंसरेंट ऑफ द रिजल्ट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस ऑफ द टू अग्निहोत्र ऑब्लेशंस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अपूर्व अननोन अनसीन परिणाम लक्षण एफेक्ट इज बीइंग मेंशन्ड हाउ दैट टू पंचधा विभज्य have divided into five parts. How we are going, every part is being told. And in those parts also, agnitvena upasanam, in the form of fire, you will have to look upon them as fire, fuel, flame, etc. What for? Uttara marga pratipatti sadhanam vidsan aha. For attaining the northern path, as a means for attaining the northern path, this particular meditation in detail is being enjoined in this Chandogya Upanishad. Asavavaloko Gautama ityadi. This yonder world, O Gautama, is certainly the first fire, etc., 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 has been said over here. But again the question rises. Yes, I am Pratragnihotra Ahuti Hute. पयादि साधने श्रद्धा पुरस्सर आवनी अग्नि समित धूम अर्चि अंगार विस्फुलिंग भावित व्हाई यू आर डूइंग सो इज बीइंग टोल्ड नाउ यू सी व्हाट व्हेन यू आर डूइंग परफॉर्मिंग द अग्निहोत्र राइट हियर इन दिस वर्ल्ड आफ्टर मैरिज व्हेन योर फर्स्ट सन हैज टेकन बर्थ इफ ऑल योर हेयर्स आर परफेक्ट विद ब्लैकनेस परफेक्ट ब्लैक हेयर्स नॉट इन अ सिंगल पार्शियल व्हाइटनेस Not single hair should partially white. 100% white. Jata putra Krishna Keshi Agni Nadanita. Vasante Brahmano. It's told month and everything at which time you can do it. Sharadi Vaisha, Grishma Rajane, Sharadi Vaisha. So therefore he is telling, what all you are seeing here, the same thing should be seen, looked upon in the fires above us. In the ascending and descending order. So first you have to understand what all are here. For that Bhashyakara says, here you are seeing that in the evening and morning, Agnihotra Ahuti Hute. Oblations, two oblations, Agni Ahuti is a Dvivachan, dual number. Hute are offered. What are the oblations? Paya Adi Sadhani. In which milk etc. are the accessories. With such accessories you are doing it. And how you are doing it? Shraddha Purusare, with total faith. Ahuniya, Agni. Where you are putting that oblations? Into the special fire called Ahuniya fire here. There it is, the Dhyuloka is the fire. Antariksha is the fire. Different fires will get up while going and coming down. Here it is, the fire is called as Ahuniya fire. And there is Samhita, fuel you are there. Smoke rises. There also is faint smoke. What is the smoke there? Then Archi, flame is there. Angaraha, the ember. And Visfulingaha, the sparks. Bhavite. All these things are seen here. And with total faith, you have got that internal kartritva, agentship within you. And you feel that I am doing this. By feeling so, by that bhavana itself, what happens? Because of that feeling, he says, kartradikarak bhavite. There you will be having, the agentship will be there in your mind. Due to which, what's going to happen? You will be attaining the result of that Agnihotra. How are you going to attain? Antariksha kramena utkramya. Antariksha kramena. By ascending the succession. Through the intermediate space. You are ascending successively one after another loka, first is intermediate space. Dhyulokam pravishyantyau. Dhyulokam pravishyantyau. Entering into the yonder world. Sukshabhute. How is that? Sukshabhute. Becoming more subtle. The person's form also becomes more and more and more subtle. Apsamvaitvat, apshabdavachya. Apsamvaitvat, by one, becomes fit to be called by the word water. because of their association with God. And also, Shraddha Hetutvachya, Shraddha Shabdavachya, and fit to be called by the word faith because you have offered all the oblations, etc., with total faith. Tayo Adhikarano Agnihi. The place where they are poured is the fire. Tat Sambandham. And all other things associated with the fire should be seen everywhere. What are the things associated? He has already told. With the fire. So fuel, smoke, ember, sparks, all those things. Samidadin. Samidadin iti ityuchyate. Or called fuel, etc. are all stated over here. Yachasavagnyadi bhavana avutyaha sapita thaiva nirdishyate. And that thinking of the two oblations as fire, etc., in which way and on which you have to look upon as what? Everything in detail, as it should be, that very way are mentioned. Tathaiva nirdishyate. Asava loko agniritiyadi. Now we'll get to the mantra. Asava loko gautamagnihi tasyaditeva samit rashmayo dhumo aharachish chandramangara nakshatrani visvalingaha. O Gautama, this yonder world is indeed, certainly, surely, what? Agni, the fire, into which after the death, this person through intermediate space successively enters into that fire. And there, tasya, of that fire, what is the samit? He said, Adityeva. Just like here, Paya Adi it was said. There it is, Aditya. Sun is the Samidha, the fuel over there. Eva, surely, certainly. Rashmayo, Dhumaha. And the rays of the sun should be looked upon as the smoke. Aha, Archi. The daytime should be understood as flame. Chandrama, Angara. And the moon as the ember, and nakshatrani, vispulingaha, and all the stars as the sparks. Bhashya. Sapita thaiva nirdishyate. Asovava loko agnihi. Surely, indeed, this yonder world is the fire. He Gautama, O Gautama. Yata atingnihotra adhikranma avaniya. Just like in this world, Agnihotra, the place in which you are doing this Agnihotra is called as, the fire is called as Ahuniya. Similarly, in that world is itself the fire for Agnihotra there. Tasya Agnehe Dhyulokakhyasya. That Tasya means Agne, of that fire. Which fire? Of the yonder world, the form of fire. The yonder world being transformed as fire. Or looked upon as fire, of that fire. Adityeva samit. The sun is itself the fuel. Tenahi iddho aso lokapati. Why you are telling that as fuel? Because tenahi iddho. Having been lit up. Iddha means lit up by the sun. The whole world becomes lit up. Because the sun rises, the whole world gets light. Being it lit up, the whole world get lit up. Therefore, tena iddha, having lit up by it, aso loko dipade, this whole world, that especially not only this world, that yonder world also gets lit up. Ataha samindhanat samit aditya. As and because it's properly lighting up the yonder world. Therefore, it is the sun is can be looked upon as fuel samit. Rashmayodomaha taduttanat. Because as soon as the sun rises, what comes out of it? The rays come out of it. Therefore, just like when it lit a fire, what comes out of the smoke comes. That the first effect of the rising of sun, as the first effect of the rising of a fire, lighting of a fire is smoke. So the first effect of rising of the sun is rays. Therefore, the rays have to be looked upon as smoke. Samidohi dhumaha uttishtate. When any fuel is properly lit up, automatically, what comes up is smoke comes up first. therefore here also it should be seen. Aha archi prakash samanya, there is a light, the bright light of the daylight. The day should be seen as what? Archihi, the flame. Aditi karitvaccha, and because it's bright light is also the effect of sun. Just like the effect of the lit flame is flame. If the fire went is lit properly, the flame is the effect of the fire itself. Similarly, this bright light of the daytime is also the effect of sun itself. Therefore, this bright daylight or the day can be looked upon as flame. Chandrama angaraha. And the moon should be looked upon as angara. Angara means ember. Aha prashame abhivyakte. Because when the fire sets, what happens? The main fire set up means you can see the ember sitting over there, all around there, the charcoal, the lit charcoal embers with heat. Not the dead, the black charcoal. Huh? The lit charcoal with heat is there in it. That's angara. Koila. Jaltava koila. The burning charcoal. Without fire, only burning charcoal is there. Fire has set and sun has set. Then what comes then? You are seeing only the burning charcoal. That's called embers here. They are nothing but the moon. Because after sunset, what are you going to see? Moon. And other than moon is the biggest one, then we are seeing that as the ember charcoal. Other than charcoal, also again small pieces here and there. Of fire pieces only. What are they? They are the sparks. Just like sparks around the big charcoal, some of these, what you call the stars, are around the moon, the big charcoal. Therefore, you have to look upon this moon as ember and the stars as sparks. Aha prasame avyakte, because when the day sets, what happens? The moon rises up. Similarly, here also, when the fire sets, you can see the burning charcoal. Archishohi prashame angara vivajyante. When the fire sets down, it's natural that we see the burning charcoal. Embers are seen. Nakshatrani vismalinga. And all the stars are none other, nothing. They have to be looked upon as the sparks. Why? Chandramaso avayava eva. They are as if like the different parts or limbs of Chandrama. Pieces of Chandrama itself. As if. Just have to do the kalpana. They are not so. As if eva, chandramasu avayava eva, just the sparks of the ember, just like the sparks are parts of ember, pieces of ember itself. A big charcoal and small charcoals are there. They are rather parts of the big one. Similarly, you have to imagine these stars are at the different parts of the moon. Therefore, the similarity arises out of that only. Viprakiranatva samanyat. What is similarity? Because here the stars are also spread all around. So there you are seeing the stars are spread all around the sky. Spreading far away is similarity. Because of that, it says you have to look upon the stars as the sparks. Eva viprakiranatva samanyat. Tasvanne tasvannagrav deva shraddham juhvati tasya ahudehe somo raja sambhavati. In that fire, the deities, devaha, shraddham juhvati. This person who is called as shraddha. You heard Bhaskara told. This person is called as by two things. By the word water and by the word shraddha, faith. This is done, perform the karma by shraddha, by faith. Therefore, it is called as faith itself. And he has done with such accessories like milk, etc., which have got more water content. As and because the accessories are associated with water, he is also associated with water and called as water. So he says, Shraddham Javati Tasya Avutehe. So out of that Ahuti also, out of that oblation, Shraddha Sukshma Jal Shraddha Padavak Lakshya. That sukshma, that subtle water form, that is itself called a shraddha over here. That has been poured into the fire, in that fire, the yonder world fire. Out of that what comes? Tasya avadehe. The result of that Ahuti, the result of that oblation is Soma Raja ki utpatti. Soma Raja, called as Soma, comes out of it. The result of it is that.